Good morning. Welcome to another morning of Pew Packers. Let's go ahead and jump right into it. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his eye. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus died for all the children of the world. Jesus rose for all the children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus rose for all the children of the world. So we're going to jump right into our Bible story today. It's kind of a longer one. I've got a time limit, so we're going to go ahead and jump right into it. So let's do it.
Good morning. Our story this morning is Saul becomes a Christian, and you can find this story in Acts chapter 8 and 9. You may have heard of Paul the Apostle, but he wasn't always known by that name. In his earlier life, he was known as Saul of Tarsus, and he was a Pharisee. This means he belonged to a religious group which did not agree with the Christian gospel. Saul first appeared in the Bible as an enemy to Christians, someone who hated them. The first time we hear of Saul is when Stephen the Christian was accused of causing trouble. Saul was there watching and listening while the accusers threw stones at Stephen. Saul was witness to this man's death. Later, Saul was busy hounding other Christians. He had an amazing experience. It happened as he was headed off to Damascus. His mission was to find, capture, punish, or destroy as many Christians as he could. So that's bad, right? But listen to what happens next. Suddenly, a bright light appeared and Saul fell to the ground. He heard a voice speaking to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Saul knew who was speaking to him and it made him very scared. The voice was the voice of Jesus. Saul had heard about the resurrection, but he didn't want to believe it. Now he was confused and trembling, and Saul said, "Who are you?" "I am Jesus," said the voice, "the one who you are persecuting." Saul knew that he was beaten. He changed completely from someone who wanted to kill Christians to someone who wanted to serve the Lord Jesus. "What do you want me to do, Lord?" asked Saul. Jesus told Saul to go to Damascus. "When you get there, you will know what to do," said Jesus. But when Saul got up and tried to go there, he realized that he was blind. He was blind for 3 days and three nights. Saul did not eat or drink, but at least he was in the city of Damascus, and there he waited. Meanwhile, a Christian named Ananias had heard from Jesus too. "Go to the street called Straight," said Jesus, "and when you get there, you will find a man called Saul of Tarsus. I want you to lay your hands on him and pray that he may receive his sight." Ananias wasn't very keen on meeting Saul because he had heard a lot about him. "Don't be afraid," said Jesus. "I have chosen him to do great things for me. He will take the gospel to many nations and to kings and rulers and the people of Israel." So Ananias set off, and sure enough, he found Saul. "Brother Saul," he said, "Jesus has sent me to you, the same Jesus that you met on the road to Damascus. I have come to tell you that Jesus is about to heal your eyes and also fill you with the Holy Spirit." So he laid his hands on Saul, and suddenly Saul could see again. From that time on, Paul became a preacher of the Bible and a great leader among Christians. He devoted his life to outreach, to church planting, and to setting a good examples for other Christians. He also traveled far and wide, suffering many trials, but his determination was to do as much for Jesus as possible before he died, and his name was changed to Paul the Apostle. This story teaches us that through Jesus we can do great things for God and leave our old life far behind. So Saul was someone who was not doing the right thing, and people feared him, but because of Jesus, he was changed. This is a great example for our lives, because no matter what, we can always turn our lives around and work for Jesus. I hope you guys got a lot out of the story, and I look forward to our next one.
Wasn't that a great story? We can learn so much from the Apostle Paul, not only the things that he does, but also the transformation that he made. Thank you so much for being with us today, and we hope to see you next week. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Thank you so much for being with us today.